All right, let's focus on hockey's labor front on Tuesday when the NHL came up with an offer that included the magical phrase 50-50 split of hockey-related revenues. People assumed the end of the lockout was near. Not so fast. On Thursday, the Players Association answered the league's offer by coming up with three offers of their own. All three were rejected by Gary Bettman and his merry band of owners. Arash Madani reports from Toronto.
Gary Bettman was at the NHL Players Association offices for no more than an hour Thursday. Donald Fehr and the union presented three counteroffers to the league, which the commissioner and his brass swiftly turned down and then promptly left for New York.
After the proposal was made, they did what they've done before. They take a very few minutes. They don't think about it very much. They don't analyze it. They don't talk to the other owners. They don't do anything. They take less than 10 minutes. And we are told all three proposals are rejected in their entirety. But if you had been in the room, the vibe you would have gotten is, unless you're prepared to sign with very minor variations, don't bother us.
I don't know if their willingness to negotiate has really shown through their offers. They've been kind of hardline offers, take it or leave it.
Bettman was steadfast that beyond minor tweaks, the league will not budge on its latest offer with the 50-50 split presented Tuesday.
I view the proposal that was made by the Players Association in many ways a step backward. The proposal that we made, so we can be clear about it, at 50-50 and all the other things, was the best that we could do.
If you assume that's their best offer, why in the world did we see it 4 weeks into a lockout?
The third player's proposal was the most interesting. The PA would take half the pie so long as owners would honor contracts already signed.
I don't believe that conducting negotiations and getting into the specifics publicly and characterizing them and mischaracterizing and baiting them is helpful. The fact is we're nowhere close. I'm not in the mode of trying to either lecture or threaten the players.
When people ask for money, they usually say, give me your money or I'm going to hurt you. They don't say, give me your money and I'm going to hurt you. And that's kind of the point we joke about, but that's what we're at.
And where we are appears to be nowhere near a resolution.
I had hoped, that the approaches we'd taken today would put us within range. So far, apparently, it's not true.
Bettman not only said Thursday was a step backwards, but suggested the league may be close to making a decision on canceling the Winter Classic. That under these circumstances and this uncertainty, the NHL would not commit the millions of dollars required if they don't believe they'll be playing. Arash Madani, Sportsnet, Toronto.
All right, thanks, Arash. So what's the big deal here? Both the league and its players have now put forth offers that include a 50-50 split of hockey-related revenues. Isn't slicing the $3.3 billion pie right down the middle the obvious solution? Well, Darren Millard and the Hockey Central panel will tell you it is just not that simple.
So in a week that showed indications of progress, disintegrated very rapidly, along with Nick Kypreos and John Shannon. Nick, start with you. So much was said today, but what continues to bother me is how can 50-50, which both sides have said that they proposed, be interpreted so differently?
Well, it's interpreted differently because now we're past the 50-50. Whether or not you want to split hairs and say on proposal one or two that it's a gradual stage, or the third proposal where it's let's get to 50-50 right away, we're beyond that. Where we are right now is a fight over money. Money that still sits on the players' current contracts. The owners want right away in the form of 13%, and the players are sitting there going, no. That was negotiated in good faith. You don't get to touch that money. We'll give you money moving forward, but don't get a dime of us on our back contracts.
Of the 2012-2013 contracts.
Absolutely, or anything that's signed prior. They want them essentially to honor their current contracts, and Gary wants a chunk of it back.
I tell you what, that is the only issue really that is holding all of this up at this point. And some will look back and say, well, hold on, there's a precedent for that. In 2004, the players gave 24% back. Can they not give more? I'm not suggesting they should. I think that the players, 60% of them are under contract, should be given all of their money and then go to 50-50. It's not the end of this contract, the end of the collective bargaining that's at issue, it's the first 2 years.
The big difference was the players gave it to them in 2004.
They volunteered it.
And now the league is demanding it.
The players that aren't signed right now, they're going to take a hit.
They are.
A big hit.
They are going to take the squeeze.
A week to go before the NHL says, you're not going to get an 82-game schedule if an agreement is not in place. That's a lot of road to cover in a short period
of
time.
Well, I think the league thought, for the most part, they were going to work with their agreement from Tuesday, or their proposal from Tuesday, and then tweak it for the next 6 days. But I will tell you right now that there isn't a deal by next Wednesday night at midnight. I suspect on Thursday the 25th, we're going to see the cancellation of a boatload of games, probably the calendar year, and the Winter Classic, and the All-Star Game.
Kippy, any part of you believe that this deal can be consummated inside of a week for an 82-game season?
Yeah, highly unlikely, because there's a lot of steam to blow off basically from the last 24 hours. But I will tell you this, a lot of players sitting there today studying what happened in the NBA and thinking that this blueprint looks awfully familiar in terms of what's going to transpire for them. So that means some wiggle room down the road. They don't care if it's 82 games, 72 games, or 62 games. What they care is about a better deal. And you factor in that a lot of those owners were involved with the NBA and the same law firm. So everybody believes that this may still get done, but on a shorter scale, much like the NBA.
If you do a shorter season, it's not a $3.3 billion business.
Now you walk through my stop sign. That's traveling. And pick up your NBA theme. Today was one big air ball.